Students, this is Anthony Christie Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering, bringing to you eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In this presentation, I'll be discussing about the application of the Cayley-Hamilton theorem to find inverse of a matrix and power of a matrix. To begin with, if we consider a polynomial given by equation 1, the polynomials of matrices can be constructed on square matrix A, which is given by f of a, where t is replaced by the square matrix a, and the constant term an is replaced by an into I, where I is the identity matrix, which is the same size as matrix A. The eigenvalues and eigenvectors can be defined as follows. If we consider a square matrix of order n, then if there exists an n-tuple in Rn, where the n-tuple is written as a column vector leading to Ax equal to lambda x, then lambda is said to be an eigenvalue and x is the corresponding eigenvector. The word eigen is derived from the German, which means something special or characteristic. To understand this, if we consider a membrane or an image of a circular shape, the transformation t of x equal to Ax resulting in an elliptical image or a membrane, we are interested in the direction or the points which does not change its direction. If it does, it just changes in the opposite direction. If lambda 1 is or lambda 2 is positive, the direction remains the same. If they are negative, they are in the opposite direction. So there is just a change in the magnitude of the vector, and if there is a change in the direction, it will be in the opposite direction. So we are interested in finding such vectors which describe the special points or the characteristics of the image or the membrane. To find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, now we have a square matrix A multiplied to a column vector X, whereas the right-hand side is lambda x, that is a scalar multiplied to a column vector. So to bring about a similarity, we introduce the identity matrix I. So equation 4 is Ax equal to lambda I into x, which on rearranging results in A minus lambda I into x equal to 0. Equation 5 represents a homogeneous system of equations. We have to find the value of lambda such that we get a non-trivial solution for x. The condition for non-trivial solution would be that rank of a minus lambda I is less than n, which implies the echelon form of a minus lambda I will be having a zero row at the bottom, which also means that the determinant of a minus lambda I should be zero to get a non-trivial solution. So that results in the characteristic equation, determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0, which is a polynomial equation of degree n. The roots of this characteristic equation are called eigenvalues. Now the Cayley-Hamilton theorem is stated as follows. Every square matrix satisfies its own characteristic equation. That means if we substitute the square matrix A in its characteristic equation, the result will be a zero, which is obvious if we replace it in the determinant A minus lambda I. If I replace lambda with A, I get zero. That does happen when we replace lambda with A in the polynomial equation as well. Now the characteristic equation can be written as follows. For a second order matrix, it is given by lambda squared minus trace of A into lambda plus determinant of A equal to 0. Now TR of A is the trace of the matrix A, which is the sum of the principal diagonal elements. For a third order matrix, the characteristic equation would be minus lambda cube plus trace of A into lambda squared minus sum of the principal minors into lambda plus determinant A equal to 0. Now, if we apply theory of equations to these characteristic equations, we find that the sum of the eigenvalues is equal to trace of the matrix, and the product of the eigenvalues is equal to the determinant. To illustrate the application of the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, I have chosen this example. We compute A inverse and A power 4 using Cayley-Hamilton theorem. To achieve this, first we have to find the characteristic equation, which is given by equation 1. Now, for the matrix A given, the trace of the matrix is 2. The principal minors are minus 3, minus 1, and 3. And determinant is minus 2. So the characteristic equation would be given by equation 2. According to Cayley-Hamilton theorem, we have minus a cube plus 2a squared plus a minus 2i equal to 0, which is obtained by replacing lambda by a in equation 2, and the constant term 2 is replaced with 2i. To find A inverse, all we have to do is introduce A inverse in the equation. So we multiply throughout with A inverse and simplify this. Rearranging will give us A inverse equal to 1 by 2 minus A squared plus 2A plus I. So substituting for A squared, A and I results in equation 8, which is the inverse of the square matrix A. Now, to find the power of the matrix A, we have to bring in the appropriate term. We require to evaluate A power 4. So I multiply throughout with A, which results in this equation. Rearranging gives me A power 4 equal to 2a cube plus a squared minus 2a. When we apply the Cayley-Hamilton theorem here, we can replace a cube in terms of a squared, a and I. So the equation reduces to a power 4 is equal to 5a squared minus 4i. So I can evaluate a power 4 in terms of a squared and I. So a power 4 is given by equation 10. Thank you.